The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents...
Marshall. You're here for a tale of mystery? Something to curdle the blood and set the heart pounding? But I planned a small history and geography lesson, and you must trust me. I won't fail you. You shall have your mystery and be well satisfied by what is in store.
Craig says you know all there is to know about devil dances and fire walking and hexes and all the marvelous magic here in Ceylon. I want to learn.
Oh, my dear Lisa, no one could know all there is to know about such things.
But you believe in the magic, don't you?
Believe? Oh, I wouldn't say that, no. I'd rather say I don't understand certain baffling things that happen here. Very strange indeed. And you shall sample them all.
Our drama, Hexed, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Nancy Moore and stars Roberta Maxwell. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Exlax. I'll be back shortly with Act One. In about 400 B.C., Islam traders in the Indian Ocean landed on an island which later would be called Ceylon. So beautiful was it that the Mohammedans called it Second Eden. That small jeweled island off the tip of India is shaped like a teardrop. You will attach significance to that fact after you've heard the story of Lisa. I give you Gary Hutchins, who knows the story far better than I.
Lisa came to Ceylon first as a tourist. She had the good taste to fall in love not only with the island, but with Craig Peters, and he with her. He with her indeed, at first sight. Craig's tea estate is next but one to mine. I remember the night of the day he met her. He came across for our Thursday evening of chess.
It's no good, Gary. I can't play. I can't concentrate.
Oh, you're not feeling ill, Craig?
Well, in a manner of speaking, yes. It's called love sickness, and it's terminal, my friend. For 1 hour today, I was in the company of a young American by name Lisa Phillips. And unless I marry her, I shall die.
It's rather extreme, isn't it?
I want you to meet her.
Yes, I should think so. Every mama in Ceylon has been trying for years to matchmake you and her daughter, and you've avoided marriage like the monsoon. And now after 1 hour, you... Oh, yes. Fetch her around.
Tomorrow, then. And you'll tell me in private if I've gone mad.
Craig brought her around, and he had not gone mad. Oh, she was all he said. A tawny-haired, lovely creature who brought excitement with her. If I hadn't been twice her age, I'd have given Craig a run for it. Instead, in 2 months, I stood best man at the wedding. A week or so later, I was at their place for dinner. Lisa and I were having drinks in the garden while Craig was off seeing to the dinner wine.
Gary, you're Craig's dearest friend. I hope you'll be mine.
Ah, you have my word on that.
Most bachelors resent intruders. At least the one who's still a bachelor.
Well, not this bachelor. Who in the world could possibly resent you?
No one, I hope.
Oh, wait. There could be someone.
Who?
Oh, no. No one who matters. It's only that Signori's servants are fiercely loyal, and they can be fiercely jealous as well.
You mean Fonseca, don't you?
Why, has something happened already?
No, not really, but I know Fonseca has been Craig's head servant for 7 years. He's used to a bachelor household. Why wouldn't he resent an upstart female American making changes? Giving orders.
Oh, yes, Fonseca's spoiled, there's no doubt about it. But he hasn't been rude in any way, has he?
Oh, no, not rude. But there is one thing. He won't look at me, Gary. At the ground, through me, beyond me, but never at me.
Oh, my dear child, you've much to learn about the customs of Ceylon. Male servants are taught never to look directly at Western women, white women.
Oh, I am ignorant. Be my teacher, Gary. I don't want to make any mistakes. Will you promise me something else?
Oh, done.
Craig says you know all there is to know about devil dances and fire walking and hexes and all the marvelous magic in Ceylon. I want to learn.
Why, dear, no one could ever know all there is to know about such things.
But you believe in the magic, don't you?
Believe? No, I wouldn't say that. I'd rather say I don't understand certain things that happen here. How, for example, how do they walk on those hot coals?
They really do. There isn't any trick.
Oh, there's none, absolutely none. It can't be explained by tricks or gimmicks or hypnosis or drugs. They walk and they are not burned. Not everyone can do it, you understand, but some, yes. Now, how do you explain it? Beyond me.
The devil dancers. Do they really heal sickness?
Sometimes, or so it seems. In the West, of course, we'd say it was just remission of a disease.
You don't say that, do you?
Lisa, I don't know what to say. Oh, here comes the groom.
Hello. Sorry to be so long. A tiresome Zahananda was hanging about. Had a word with her. Had to send her packing.
Who is Zahananda?
Oh, she's a witch doctor Cook is friendly with.
Oh, darling, I could have met a witch doctor.
Lisa would like to have her to dinner, I do think.
Well, I doubt you'd like sitting across from that toothless old hag in her dirty rags and tatters.
Well, I'd like to have met her at least.
Sorry, my sweet. It didn't occur to me. I'd have brought her around to the terrace.
As I recall, Zahananda's a white witch, Lisa, meaning a good witch. She breaks spells and hexes meant to do harm.
Oh, tell me about hexes. How does someone get hexed?
Oh, Gary, why don't you tell her about the little evil containers? Sort of capsules, my darling, that get buried in the garden. Fonseca, fill our glasses, please.
Yes, Master.
I never see or hear Fonseca arrive, but he's always near when Master wants him.
Ah, yes, well, a very special talent he has, haven't you, Fonseca?
Yes, sir.
Fonseca, you tell Lady about hexes. What gets buried in gardens to put evil spells on poor doomed souls?
It's not good to talk of hex, Master.
Aha, so that's it. All right. All right, Lisa, my love. In the magic wicked capsule, the most important ingredient is something personal from the intended victim.
So it is.
Like what?
Oh, a lock of hair, fingernail paring.
Next of importance, something the victim has worn or used a good deal. Say, a ring.
Ah, but a missing ring might be noticed early on, so something less important is much safer. A handkerchief, say.
What else is buried?
Oh, a bit of food left on the victim's plate. Any food, any plate.
Craig, darling, stop making fun of it. Anything else in the capsule?
Oh, yes, a lot. I don't know what. Mysterious bits. I doubt that anyone knows except the chap who cast the spell. You know, I saw a hex thing once dug up in Bundy Smith's garden. It was meant for him. He'd sacked his cook, and Cook was after revenge on poor old Bundy.
Yes, I remember that time.
Did Bundy get sick? Die?
Oh, no, sweetheart. Nothing happened to him at all.
Because the hex thing was found in time?
Possibly. If it's found and destroyed, it loses its power.
Gary, what was in that capsule you saw?
Some slimy, foul-smelling stuff, black. Nobody on Earth could tell what the lumps in it were. Except I could say one of them was a scorpion.
Ooh,
yes,
ooh.
I hear bat's teeth are in them, too. They have to be taken from a living bat, not a dead one. Very potent bat's teeth.
Oh, Craig, old boy, will you look at your bride? Those matchless eyes are positively on fire with excitement.
It is exciting. In my whole life, there's never been anything as exciting as this.
We were warned that night, Craig and I. Warned, but we didn't hear. Lisa's interest in magic and the occult already was too extreme, even unnatural. We did notice as the months passed that she believed in all the odd things we investigated, but we still paid little attention, more amused than anything. And then three alarming events happened in rapid succession.
My shoe. The shoes I meant to wear tonight. In one of them, a scorpion.
Ah, yes. Hateful little beasts. Well, it had to happen sooner or later, Pat.
For your sake, I hoped it never would, but well, it is an island of creepy, crawly things.
A scorpion can... Oh, Craig, it can be part of a hex. Scorpions are signs of evil.
Lily, what is happening?
A bat in this room. There, the drapes at the top. Kill it.
Lily.
Kill it, I said.
We'll catch. We'll take out. Not kill.
You will kill it.
What's going on? What's happening here?
Take me out of this room. Just take me out.
What's the matter?
Stand close to me. Help me. Don't let it come near me.
Well, don't let what come near you?
Close the door. It might follow.
Oh, yes. All right.
Oh, my darling, what on earth are you afraid of?
The bat.
Oh, is that what this is all about?
I told Fonseca to kill it. I ordered him. He refused. He wouldn't. He hates me.
Dearest, it's against his religion to kill anything. You know that. Any living thing.
He'd have killed it if you gave the order.
No, he wouldn't.
He said he'd catch it.
Well, that's what they always do, the Sinhalese. You've seen him take a cloth, pop it over a spider, an ant, and carry it outdoors and let it go. Well, the same thing with a bat.
No.
No?
He'll carry it to a witch. The witch will take teeth from a living bat.
My poor darling, you're talking about hexes again.
Craig!
Coming, lady.
I didn't call you. Go away. Send master.
Statue? Lady.
It fell from the wall. It could have killed me.
It is the Lord Buddha.
Don't touch it. I want master to see where it fell.
The Buddha come down from the wall. It's very bad sign, lady.
I know what it is, a sign of Fonseca. I told you to get master.
Master, come.
How do you know? How do you always know?
Master, come.
Lisa.
Comes and you go.
Oh, darling, what's happened now?
Look.
Oh, I say. Oh, what brought that down?
I won't talk in front of Fonseca. I tell him to go and he just stands there. Make him go, Craig.
Fonseca?
Yes, Master. I go.
Oh, Craig. I could have
Now, Lisa, it had to be an accident. No one in Ceylon, witch doctor, servant, no Sinhalese would tamper with an image of Buddha. Even you should know it's sacred.
But it fell.
Yes, because it has sat up there on that pedestal for years. It's huge, carved of heavy teak wood. Its weight made it gradually inch forward, and finally it has made it simply lose its balance. Now, that's not black magic.
Well, why did it lose its balance just when I was under it? That very minute, something evil. Oh, darling, take me away from this horrible place. Please, let's live in England.
Now, you know I've every penny tied up in the tea estate.
Well, you can get your money out. Gary would buy it. You know he would. I loathe Ceylon. Loathe this estate. Please sell it.
When you came here, you loved the island.
How could I know what it would be like to live here? That someone would hate me enough to...
Now what?
Fonseca, he's just outside the door.
Well, he's always near me, Lisa. You know that. He's trained that way.
Oh, Craig, don't you see? Fonseca took the bat's teeth and the scorpion and paid a witch doctor to cast a spell on me.
Oh, this is rubbish. This is rot.
Last night, out there in our garden, an evil thing was buried. In it is something that was me. Hair from my brush and something I used and food off my plate. All of it out there, in that thing.
Some magician said abracadabra, the powers of darkness went to work and you're under a wicked spell.
Yes, that's what made the statue fall.
My love, you can't believe that. Now stop. We'll just stop. We'll get to the bottom of this, all right? Fonseca, come in here.
He won't admit anything.
There is no more loyal servant on the island.
To you. Not to me.
Yes, master.
There have been too many accidents lately, Fonseca. Lady believes there's a hex. Now, do you believe that?
I not know, master. If spell on a lady, Zahananda can break spell.
Well, Lisa, is that what you want? You mean to send Fonseca down the mountain to the jungle and bring that witch woman up here for tea and mumbo-jumbo?
I don't want any witch near me. What kind of a place do I live in where there are witches? I want you to sell the estate and take me away.
I can't do that.
I speak, Master.
Yes, Fonseca.
Not safe. Lady, stay. Is best lady go from Ceylon.
Accidents or human malevolence? Psychic phenomena or the cunning of man? We have no certain answer, not yet. All we know is that the hobgoblins of superstition and fear have come to dwell with Lisa. And Fonseca's Not Safe Lady Stay hasn't helped matters, as you will soon see in Act Two. Psychic phenomena have been described down the labyrinths of history. The Bible is rife with it. In ancient Greek, Plutarch wrote of Calpurnia's dream predicting Caesar's murder. Abraham Lincoln dreamed of his own corpse lying in state. John F. Kennedy was warned by psychics not to go to Dallas. Are we to call Lisa gullible and a fool to believe a spell has been put upon her by psychic forces? I, for one, say a qualified no. What does Gary Hutchins say?
The Buddha statue had crashed from the wall about 10 in the morning. By 11, Lisa in tears sat on my veranda telling me the whole sickening story. How she had changed in one short year. From a merry, laughing girl to a shaken, distraught, hardly recognizable young woman. Still beautiful, oh yes, she would always be that. And now as she talked, it became more and more evident that she had been alarmed long before the scorpion, the bat, and the statue. Why hadn't she told me? Why, Lisa?
I didn't want to admit what was happening to me. Even admit it to myself. Much less to you, and certainly not to Craig. I thought I could handle it. I thought all the fears would go away. Not just to Fonseca, the others, too.
What others?
A sense of evil forces everywhere. Lurking about, watching for the vulnerable, ready to spring.
Lisa.
I know how it sounds, but I can't keep it to myself any longer. I have to talk to someone. At least you won't think I've lost my senses. You believe there are such forces.
Oh, now wait, my dear. I've said there are certain things here that I don't understand, but belief in evil forces waiting to spring... No, Lisa, no.
You know there are spells and hexes. You know they work. People sicken and die, or they're killed.
Psychosomatic. The victim's belief in them makes them work, not magic forces. Now, you believe Fonseca has cast a spell on you, and you yourself are making yourself sick. A scorpion, the bat, are perfectly normal occurrences in Ceylon.
A falling statue is a normal occurrence?
Well, it could be.
Psychosomatically, I made the statue fall, nearly killing me. Is that what you'll say next, Gary?
It's almost as if you want to believe your hex.
I want to leave Ceylon. That's all I want. Oh, please, please tell Craig you'll buy the estate.
My dear child, I don't want to lose you and Craig, but even if I could bear the thought, I couldn't afford to buy another estate.
And I thought you were my friend.
After Lisa left, not in the least comforted, I'm afraid, Craig showed up.
Well, she's sensitive, Gary. She's impressionable. More than most.
Imaginative. Childlike.
Yes, why didn't we realize that?
Oh, we did, but we didn't realize. But the devil dancers and fireworks, astrologists and fortune tellers would affect that sensitive, childlike, impressionable girl.
Yeah, should have known. Should have protected her.
That's my fault. You always said they were rubbish. I took her to most of the rotten things.
Well, I let her go. Thought they were entertainment for her. Never thought she'd take the bloody stuff seriously. I say, do you know what she has in her sitting room? One of those huge, grotesque masks of the Cobra God.
Devil dancer's mask?
Well, I thought it was for decoration. Turns out she got it for protection, to drive away evil spirits.
Good Lord. Look here, Craig, I hate to say this, but maybe you ought to sell out after all.
Well, after that statue fell, it's all I thought of. But I mean, what do I know about except tea? Ever since I came down from Oxford. Tea, Ceylon, all I bloody know.
Right. Oh, well, Lisa will come round, come to her senses. She's a sensible young woman, bright. It's just a phase she has to go through. She'll come out on the other side, all right? We'll talk sense into her, the two of us.
The next morning, there was another scene. Lisa missed a star sapphire earring, a favorite. She was quite certain it was buried in the garden. Old Craig tried to reason with her, but she walked off, went to their room, and closed the door. He had some business to attend to, some trouble with one of his foremen. He got rid of the fellow as soon as he could, and straight away went to find Lisa in their bedroom.
Lisa? Lisa?
Yes, Craig?
Ah, there you are. Where were you?
In the garden.
Oh, now, don't tell me you've been digging about for that thing.
Yes.
Well, did you find it?
No.
Yes, well, jolly well right you didn't.
How could I? I thought I'd find a freshly dug place with the earth recently put back, but the gardener has stirred everything up. Just the same, it's there, Craig. That terrible little thing is there, I know it.
Demonology among the flowers. Spade up the whole acre of garden, and you won't find any hocus pocus.
Are you putting on a tie?
I'm going down to Colombo on business. I have to see Fulsham about the next tea shipment. You want to come along?
Would I stay in this house without you?
Well, you better change then. Hey, wear that new yellow frock, will you, darling? You look ravishing here, huh?
Yes.
Then hurry it up. I'm late already.
All right.
I'll fetch your dress while you shower. Where's the key to the wardrobe?
Oh, I don't. Yes, my pocket. Here.
Oh, thanks. There
you go. It's hanging right there in the front.
Oh, let me see. Bottom dresses, is it? Ah, here we are.
My yellow hat, too, please.
Oh, I say.
What's the matter?
Your frock, darling. It's torn. Come here. Look here.
Well, it couldn't possibly be torn. I hung it up there and... Oh, it is torn. Craig, not torn. Come.
Well, how the devil could... What are you doing, darling?
Look. Oh, dear, look. All of them. This dress, this one, this. All cut.
This is a nasty bit of business.
Stop pretending you don't know what it means.
Well, I said it was a nasty bit of business,
darling. The eggs, the clothes, the victim's clothes. Slashed where they cover up the heart. A sign that the heart will stop beating.
Now, darling, I'm sure that there's a reasonable...
The other awful things could have been accidents. They weren't, but they could have been. But not this. And nothing human did. I had the key in my pocket.
Oh, now, hold on a minute.
Will you at least admit it's not an accident?
All right. Admit it. But sorcery, magic, evil spirits did not slash your clothes.
Nothing will convince.
This can be explained just like the other mischief.
Oh.
Well, all right, you sacked your maid last week, Nirmala, huh? She had a key. Did she give it back to you before she left?
No.
There you are. She's taken this primitive revenge. She knew it would frighten you, and it has, and that's all there is to this. Now come along, darling. Tidy up, and let's be off to Colombo.
That's all you have to say about what's happened.
Sweetheart, it's settled. Well, it's not actually settled, is it, Nirmala? Could have loosed that statue. She knows you sit near it. Fonseca! Fonseca!
Yes, Master.
Please, darling, don't let him see you like this.
Oh, nothing could please him more.
Yes, Master.
When I get back from the city, I want you to have Nirmala here.
Cannot, sir. Nirmala have gone to Calcutta.
To Calcutta? Well, when did she leave?
Past week, sir. Oh,
you see, she couldn't have done it. I put the yellow dress in the wardrobe yesterday.
Fonseca, you are head servant here, responsible for all other servants. Look here at lady's clothes.
Master.
Fonseca, you will find out who is doing these tricks and put a stop to it. You will break this so-called spell, or I'll sack the lot of you.
Master, please. Fonseca, speak.
Well?
Lady, go quick from Ceylon. Clothes cut over heart, sign of death. Death soon. Lady, go.
Craig, please don't drive so fast. I'm afraid of the curve.
Don't nag, darling. I'm used to the mountain roads. Anyhow, I'm not going very fast.
You are.
You're afraid of everything these days, aren't you? Look yonder down the gorge, eh? Three elephants having a bath.
Craig, one last time. Will you sell the estate and take me away from here?
One last time, no. No, my darling, no.
I see.
One last time, will you use your perfectly good head and get over this obsession? No fetish, no harpy, no evil eye or witch doctor has conjured up this voodoo. It is being done by human hands, and we will find out directly whose hands they are.
Maybe we already know.
Oh, not again, Lisa. Now, I trust Fonseca absolutely. He only said you should leave because he believes this hex nonsense, too.
I didn't mean Fonseca.
Yes, well, you certainly don't mean Nirmala. She's in Calcutta.
No.
Then who?
My husband.
Lisa!
Are you the one who wants to get rid of me because I've changed? Are you the one trying to frighten me into leaving Ceylon without you?
Good Lord, Lisa, you can't mean this.
All right, forget I said. You're right, my darling Craig. I'm obsessed. Afraid of everything and everyone, even you.
How could you possibly think for one second...
I don't want to talk about it.
Yes, well, neither do I.
That hairpin curve is next.
Now, don't worry, darling. The brakes are all right. Look, while I see Fulsham, why don't you buy some clothes? A lot of clothes. You've hardly a frock left.
If I have time.
Why won't you have time?
I have an errand. May I take the car?
Of course. What errand?
Never mind.
Now, look here, Lisa. You're not going to one of those fortune tellers, all right? You're mixed up enough as it is, and I won't have it.
You don't need to have it, and neither do I. I already know my fortune. It's decided. I suddenly see it clear, and nothing will change it.
What suddenly does she see, or think she sees? How ominous that she could think her adoring and patient husband could... Still, how well do we ever really know anyone? Friends of criminals, neighbors of rapists, mothers of murderers. How often they say, he was a good boy, and believe it. What are we to believe of Craig Peters? Act 3 very likely will tell us. Beautiful island paradise is paradise lost to Lisa. But let me digress a little. The island's name, when she came there, was still Ceylon. In the recent past, it has taken back its ancient name, Sri Lanka, meaning the resplendent. The word rings sadly upon the ear now, for there is nothing resplendent in our story. Let Gary Hutchins finish it.
I had little to do with the rest of Lisa's story. Certainly no control over it. I was told it later in bits and pieces by those involved, even the chap you'll meet now. What was the errand Lisa had in Colombo? The errand she would not explain to Craig? She drove to a public garage where she and Craig were not known.
Oh, yes, petrol, Mum. You'll have to draw a bit closer to the tank.
No petrol, thank you. I'd like to speak to a mechanic, please.
Oh, that'll be myself, ma'am. What's the trouble?
There isn't any trouble, not yet.
Uh-huh.
But I think there will be. I expect an accident.
Beg pardon, ma'am?
Well, I don't know how to say this except just say it. I think someone wants me to have an accident. I think he'll do something to the car just before he knows I'll drive it.
Sure, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I want you to show me how he could do that. Things he could do to the engine or brakes or whatever. Can you?
Well, I expect I can, Mum. And you'll check the lot before you take a drive, is that it?
Yes.
Yeah.
You're English, aren't you?
Yes, yes. Came out from the UK straight after the war.
Then there's no use telling you this trouble I'm having may be a hex. You English laugh at such things.
Oh, not me, Mum. I'm out here a long time now. Oh, I've seen some queer things I have. If you're under a spell, Mum, showing you the insides of your motor car won't stop what's meant to be. You'll want the witch woman's Ananda for that.
Until today, I was sure about the spell. Now I think maybe a man wants what's been happening to me to look like a hex. Then he won't be blamed when show me how to check the car, please.
Right, right. Well, first we just lift the bonnet here and have a good look inside.
Lisa, you're not eating.
I can't.
Oh, the curry's excellent. After that beastly Columba lunch, tastes marvellous.
It tastes... Oh, send Mogra out.
Why?
I can't talk with him in here. Can't you do anything I ask?
Mogra, leave the room, please. We'll ring if we need you.
Aye, aye.
Where's Fonseca? Why isn't he hovering?
Well, I should think you'd be pleased.
I am. But not with my food. It tastes bitter.
Oh, darling, this is absurd. I just said it tastes marvelous.
Well, yours isn't bitter, of course, not yours. These things only happen to me. I feel sick, Craig.
It's your imagination.
Of course. I'm going outside. I've got to get some hay.
Look, darling, I'm sorry. I said what I did. You do look a bit funny. I'll come with you.
No, I don't want you to come. Eat your dinner. You can sit there serenely knowing yours isn't poison.
Well, nor is yours. Oh, goodness gracious. Well, tomorrow I'll take a sample to Columbo and have it tested.
If tomorrow isn't too late. Tomorrow. Tomorrow. Oh, who's there? Fonseca?
Yes, lady.
Why are you out here?
Tonight, lady.
What does that mean? Stop following me.
Speak. With you, lady.
You're only an ignorant servant, and I will not talk to you. Go inside at once. Did you hear me?
Yes, lady. Ignorant servant, go.
Before you do, why don't you advise me it's best if lady runs for her life and leaves Ceylon?
Yes, lady. Go. Run for life.
What's happened, darling?
My ankle. I fell. Something in the path. Fonseca put it there.
Oh, no.
Or maybe it wasn't Fonseca.
The hex again. Now, listen to me, my sweet. Please, for once, listen. Now, this time you brought this accident on yourself. You're wandering about at night, crooked paths. Now, you tripped in the dark, and that is all.
I didn't. It was meant to happen, and it did. I want the Hananda.
What?
The witch woman. I want her. If there's a spell, she'll stop it. If there isn't, then I'll know it's... Go and get her. Now, tonight. Craig!
All right, all right. Anything. Anything to put a stop to this, and we'll both be round the bend.
Take Fonseca. I'm too sick to go, and I won't stay here alone with
you. All right, my pet, yes. And that's what I know where to find this woman. Fonseca?
Yes, Master?
We're going down the mountain. Fetch the motor car, please. Fonseca, you know this whole thing with Lady is ridiculous, don't you?
No, sir.
Supernatural poltergeist putting things in a path for her to stumble over, using bats and scorpions, tumbling statues from walls, slashing girls. It's rubbish. Now, I told you to find out who is causing these things, didn't I? Why haven't you done it?
I try, Master. Could not.
Yes, well, neither can this Zananda woman. But I'll tell you who can.
Who, Master?
A fingerprint expert.
Sir?
Hands leave the print of their fingers. No two prints are alike. The lines on our fingertips are like our names signed there. The police have a way of photographing those prints. On the back of the Buddha statue, if it was tampered with, there will be fingerprints. Brakes. I'm holding right...
Oh,
this is
Master!
Damn it! I can't! The handbrake. Good Lord, the handbrake won't hold either.
Master!
Jump! Jump! Get out of here!
Master! Jump! Jump!
Thank you for the drink, Mulgrew. You can go to bed. I'll wait in the garden for Master. No need for you to wait.
What do I?
Oh, why don't you come, Craig? What's keeping you, my darling?
Lady. Lady, wait for Master.
Oh, where is he? Where's the car? How did you get here?
I walk. Brakes not good in motor car.
Where is Master?
Not here.
Answer me.
Master did.
Oh, dear heaven. Oh, no. No.
Motor car key.
Oh, Craig. Oh, darling. Oh, an accident. It was meant for me.
No, lady. For Master.
For... You did this. Tonight out here in the garden when I found you. You didn't expect me to leave the dinner table. You were just... finished doing something to the car. You knew tomorrow I was going over to Mr. Hutchins.
If Fonseca no death riding motor car, Fonseca not drive with Master.
Oh.
Police will find what prints of fingers make death in motor car brakes. Same prints of fingers on Lord Buddha's statue.
What are you talking about?
The fingers of you, lady.
Oh, how could I possibly know how to fix brakes so that... it's nonsense, it's crazy, but I take back what I said about you. Someone else is responsible for the hex. And it was on Master, too. It killed him.
No hex, lady. No hex.
Yes, there was. There was. Normala, she had the spell cast. I'm certain of it. That earring, she took it. I'm sorry I blamed you. Terribly sorry.
No spell, lady. I ring up police now.
Fonseca?
Yes, lady.
Come back. Now listen to me. I did believe I was hexed. Master didn't. I thought if I made a dreadful thing happen myself, the statue falling, clothes slashed, I thought he'd believe and take me away. I gave him every chance. I only wanted him to leave Ceylon. That's all. I never intended to hurt him. Would he listen? No. Promise to sell the estate? No. I couldn't bear to stay in this hateful place with the hex still on me, and I couldn't leave alone without money. I had to kill him. Had to.
Yes, lady.
Now I'll sell the estate myself. There'll be lots of money, some of it for you. 20,000 rupees. 20,000, all for you. Do you understand?
Understand well.
Good. Then everything's settled, isn't it?
Is settled.
Now, we do have to inform the police, but you'll say nothing about fingerprints. The brakes of the car failed. It was an accident. That's all you need to say. And now call. No, I guess it's better if I do.
Why are you standing in my way?
Not enough. 20,000 rupees.
Not? Well, that's $4,000. You've never dreamed of that much money in your life.
Not enough.
All right. $5,000. Now get out of my way.
Do not want rupee. Do not want dollar.
What in the name of heaven do you want?
Tea estate, lady.
What?
Fonseca. Be master here now.
Oh, my God.
And lady, be wife to Fonseca.
Are you mad? Wife of a...
servant, lady.
Yes.
Ignorant servant, lady.
Yes. And stay in this awful place? No. No.
Lady in prison. Or wife to Fonseca. Lady cannot go from Sidon.
No. No.
Wife or prison? Lady, decide.
No.
Rose Fonseca. She's lived for 7 years now in that house as his wife. I don't go there, of course. But I see her sometimes wandering the hillside. She's a sloven now. Barefoot like the natives, hair streaming, wearing a filthy sari. She looks...
Yes, she
looks like a witch. At once lovely, enchanting, jewel of a creature, murderer of my best friend. Do you ask why I never turned her into the police? Because life imprisonment with Fonseca, made to obey him, to wait on him, to bear his children, is far more cruel punishment than judge and jury could ever devise.
My friends, an afterthought. Hexes take many forms. Considering Lisa's fate, can we say she was not hexed? Or, to put it another way, can we say she was not under the dominion of an evil spirit? Her own, to be sure, but an evil spirit, nonetheless. I'll be back shortly. Gary Hutchins spoke of Lisa as once having been a lovely jewel. Ceylon is famous for its jewels. Fabulous gems called by early Chinese traders the crystallized tears of the first man. We're back to tears, the island shaped like a teardrop. I predicted at the start that you would attach significance to that fact after you heard the story of Lisa. Did you?
Our cast included Roberta Maxwell, Paul Hecht, and Ian Martin. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Exlax and Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.